Pandemi ikut mempersingkat harapan hidup rata-rata warga Amerika Serikat menurut pantauan Pusat Pengendalian Penyakit Menular ASCDC dari 78,8 tahun pada 2019 turun ke angka 77,8 tahun.
So it's right about a one year decline in life expectancy, and while that doesn't sound like a whole lot at a population level, this is a huge decline, and it's not something that we've seen. I mean, you have to go back to World War II, 1940s, to find a decline like this in the past.
Catatan CDC ini baru meliputi paruh pertama 2020 saat COVID pertama menganas dengan epicentrum di New York. Belum mencakup lonjakan-lonjakan berikutnya yang biasanya terjadi setelah hari libur atau long weekend.
I think what is really quite striking in these numbers is that they only reflect the first half of the year, and it doesn't really reflect the full brunt of the pandemic. So I would expect that these numbers will only get worse as we do these analyses over time.
Tapi angka 77,8 tahun ini hanyalah angka rata-rata dari harapan hidup di Amerika Serikat. Bila dipilah-pilah berdasarkan latar belakang etnis, maka ada kesenjangan cukup signifikan antara warga Amerika keturunan Eropa alias berkulit putih dengan warga Amerika berkulit hitam alias keturunan Afrika dan juga warga Amerika Hispanik atau keturunan Amerika Latin. Bagi kelompok warga terakhir terjadi penurunan harapan hidup hampir 2 tahun. Angkanya hampir 3 tahun untuk warga keturunan Afrika.
Throughout the entire pandemic, what we have seen time and time again is that our Black, Latino, Indigenous populations have really borne the brunt of this pandemic. We see that they're at increased risk of exposure because they are oftentimes in frontline, front-facing work, oftentimes low-wage work without the additional resources to protect themselves. They're often living in environments where they're more likely to transmit the virus to others who live with them. They're oftentimes living in congregate living settings that put people at risk for higher transmission.
The racial inequities that we say in coronavirus are really characteristic of the racial inequities that we see in many diseases, be it cancer, heart disease, diabetes. The focus really needs to be broad spread on getting every American adequate care, and healthcare needs to be defined as prevention as well as treatment.
Warga asli Amerika atau suku Indian belum masuk laporan CDC ini. Begitu juga warga keturunan Asia. Meski biasanya warga keturunan Asia memiliki harapan hidup terlama pada kisaran 80-an tahun. Dari Washington DC, Nova Purwadi, VOA.